But I remember before I kind of understood what graffiti was and understood what, you know, street art was, then I had no idea what it was doing there, how it got there, and who was doing it, and why they were doing it. And for me, there was this kind of like mystery about it. And that was very interesting for me because it seemed almost magical in a sense. For me, working on these types of projects that use text as kind of like this primary medium, it's about taking certain phrases or extracts or fragments of text out of their original context and in a way that almost makes them generic when they're out of, you know, out of the context of the original sentence. And I say generic not in a negative way. I think that it's interesting for me the transition that words can go through when they come from something that is deeply contextualized, deeply personal at times, has a very specific meaning, and then all of a sudden it becomes kind of like a container that the viewer fills his or her own interpretation, their own baggage, their own associations and connotations that they attribute to these phrases. And then it kind of raises a lot of question, what does text really mean? Does it really have an objective meaning, or is it entirely dependent on our personal experience? What I'm doing is I'm collecting these separate stories and combining them into one story. And of course that depends on the content that people write. Taking all the stories and cutting and pasting, editing them in a way that will create one story, kind of like a portrait of sorts, or a collective heartbreak that is comprised of separate people's stories coming from completely different backgrounds, and to create one coherent story that kind of communicates the universal notion of this. And that's essentially what I'm planning on doing for the installation, is to create this kind of like replica of a deep hole or well of oil, and then projecting kind of like the collective heartbreak story onto the surface. So it looks bottomless, looks endless, and it's reflective, so the viewer will be able to see his or herself as part of this this reservoir, almost, and also amongst the collective heartbreak. So it kind of offers an opportunity for one to see him or herself as part of this larger issue, which I think is very universal, and we kind of all experience heartbreak in different ways, whether it be romantic or otherwise. I think that it's like a very common denominator. And then later on, I'm planning on taking the even shorter fragments of these texts and placing them, creating a series of outdoor works around the city. I think what I wanted to do here was create some sort of analogy or juxtaposition between the personal and the political or the socio-economical processes that are happening here with the oil industry and the oil crisis or the rising unemployment, and kind of observe a collective heartbreak as a changing reality, and as the adaptation that is needed after heartbreak, it's the same that is needed in kind of refining yourself in your own life, in society, in on a personal or professional or financial or, you know, much more broader philosophical sense. For me, from my past experience, taking a work that's deeply personal, putting it outdoors, there's something very therapeutic about it, because it's, you let go of it to a certain extent, and you're able to see it from a certain distance that allows also interaction, and all of a sudden it's not you kind of bouncing off of yourself with it, but there are other people that are part of it and can relate to it, and then there's some sort of like a very consoling process that takes place. I don't know if I'm trying to cure the society, but I think that if there is an agenda to what I'm doing, it's kind of to allow people to recognize the humanity in other people, and then use that as kind of a starting point to just identifying the commonalities between us. Like I think that we all have the same longings, even though the content is you know, it varies and it's different. But there's still something kind of embedded in us that that is very collective, very universal, and I think that it's all around us. And I think that if people notice other people, and people notice other, you know, changes in their surroundings, and I think that if we can kind of divert or focus our attention to these everyday moments, then it really changes the way that we perceive our reality.